Jay Sanskar, till the time we have discussed about garden pea plant, how it worked, etc. So there is a one dominant trait which is tallness, okay, and recessive trait was shortness. If two T's were small, then only we could have a small pea plant. What happens when a pea plant showing two different characteristics rather than just one, or are breed with each other? What do the progeny of a tall plant with round seed and short plant with the wrinkled seed look like? So now we are not only seeing only one trait. For example, tallness or shortness is a one kind of trait. Now we are considering two type of traits. Whether plant, if one plant which is tall as well as have round seeds, while other plant which is having a dwarf and it is having a wrinkled seed. What do the progeny of a tall plant with round seed and short plant with wrinkled seed look like? So now we are supposed to give name to it, okay? So that capital T for tallness, capital R for round, and small r for wrinkled, small t is for shorter plant. They look all tall. They are all tall and have round seed. Tallness and round seed are thus dominant trait, a trait which is expressed more number of time. But what happened when F1 progeny are used as a used to generate F2 progeny by self-pollination? A Mendelian experiment will find that F2 progeny and tall plants with round seed and some were short plant with wrinkled seed. However, those would be some F2 progeny that shows new combination. Some of them would be tall but have wrinkled seed, while others would have short but have round seed. You can see as to how new combination of the trait are formed in F2 offspring when factors controlling for seed shape and color recombines from zygote leading from the F2 offspring. Thus, tall or short trait and round seed wrinkled seed traits are independently inherited. Okay, so let's just try out this particular example. Okay, for example, let's consider one is having round seed and tallness, other one is shortness and round seed and wrinkled seed. Okay, like this. Okay, so the progeny would have one of these. For example, if we have these two, then we could have round seed with shortness, okay, or round seed with tallness, or wrinkled seed with tallness, or wrinkled seed with shortness. So there is, this one is a new variety, okay, as well as this. So the topic itself says that how many kind of variety that we will get. So previously we have seen we do have TT and small TT plants. If we cross pollinated these two, we do have okay, and then if we have allowed these two plants for self-pollination, so we were having and small. So we were having one dwarf plant. So over here we have more number of varieties. So we can do this same kind of stuff for these kind of plants too. Okay.
Okay.
How do these traits get expressed? How does the mechanism of heredity work? Cellular DNA is an information source for making protein in the cell. So cellular DNA provides this information, and then according to that a protein is synthesized. But sometimes DNA copying leads to a misprint, or there is a variation, or there is a biochemical reaction. Due to that there is a slight variation in the offspring. A section of a DNA that provides information for one protein is called gene for that protein. So that particular one protein which is giving information is called gene. How do proteins control the characteristics that we are discussing here? Let us take example of tallness as a characteristic. We know that plant have hormone that can trigger the growth. It is called gibberellin hormone, which this particular hormone is controlling the growth. The amount of plant hormone made will be depend on the efficiency of the process for making it. Consider now an enzyme that is important for this process. If this enzyme works efficiently, a lot of hormone will be made and plant will be tall. If gene for the enzyme has alteration that makes the enzyme less efficient, the amount of hormone will be less and the plant will be short. Thus genes control the characteristics of trait. So if one particular gene is responsible for it, so that is going to decide what kind of plant is going to be. If interpretation of Mendelian experiment we have been discussing are correct, then both parents must be contributing equally into the DNA of the progeny during sexual reproduction. We have discussed this issue in previous chapter. If parents can help determining the trait in the progeny, both parent must be contributing a copy of the same gene. This means that each pea plant must have two sets of all genes, one inherited from each parent. For this mechanism to work, each germ cell must have only one gene cell. So each individual should have only one set of genes. While one is from the paternal, that is from father, and another one is from the mother. And out of these two, one is selected. Okay, that is because of natural selection. Okay, so we cannot choose by ourselves, it is natural selection. How do germ cell make a single set of genes from normal two copies that all other cells in body have? If progeny plant inherited a single whole gene set from each parent, then experiment explained in figure 9.5 will not work. This is because two characteristics, R and Y, would then be linked to each other, cannot be independently inherited. This explained by the fact that each gene set is present, not a single long thread of DNA, but as a separate independent pieces, each called chromosomes. Thus, each cell have two copies of each chromosome, one each from male and female parent. Every germ cell will take one chromosome from each pair, and this may be either maternal or paternal origin. When two germ cells combine, they will restore the normal number of chromosomes in the progeny, ensuring the stability of DNA of the species. Such a mechanism is inheritance, explains result of Mendelian experiment. It is used by all the sexually reproducing organisms. But asexually reproducing organism also follows similar rule of inheritance. Can we work out how their inheritance might So, if we are talking about asexual reproduction, we'll see, for take example of amoeba, what does it do at the time of reproduction? It will create a copy of itself, or it will make this kind of structure at the center of it. Then after that, there is a two separate genes are made. Okay, this kind of reproduction is done in amoeba, but right now we are talking about sexual reproduction. So what happens in sexual reproduction? For example, over here it is given to you that you are having a round, and Y stands for green color. This stands for green color, this stands for round. Okay. Another one is wrinkled, and capital Y, which shows yellow color, and this one is wrinkled G. So what happens? We have this variety. Okay. And out of them, if we cross-pollinate these two, we will have capital R, small r, capital Y, small y, or capital R, small r, capital Y, small y. So basically there is one from here, another from here, one from here, another from here. So that is kind of selection is there. So if we do have these two and we let them reproduce, what is going to be the final result? So for knowing that, let's try all the possible permutation and combination. Capital R, capital Y, small r, capital Y, then small r, small y, capital R and small y. So nothing is getting repeated. Similar kind of stuff you can do over here. Capital R, capital Y, small r, capital Y, capital R, small r, small y, and capital R, small y. So here we will have expression of R, capital Y, R, capital Y. So we are basically writing what is over here, R, capital Y, and from over here, small r, capital Y. Over here, capital R, capital Y, from this one, small y. Okay, capital R, Y as it is, capital R, Y as it is. So if we go on doing this, we know that only one time capital R, that means round seed, only one time capital Y, that means a green seed. Okay, so over here we will have all the round seeds. Okay, first two would be yellow in color also. So that is how it is expressed. Okay, so over here there is a diagram which is given to you. You can easily understand it. Okay, how the traits are decided. Okay, next topic is sex determination. So that would be in next session. Thank you.